So my experience setting up a new laboratory at Cambridge was really rewarding. I was lucky enough to be given a research budget to start a new lab. I was given new office space that happened to be the former office of Watson and Crick, no less. And I was able to hire new PhD students and mentor graduate students and think about what technologies are necessary, what equipment do you need, and the university really provided the time and space for me to build out a world-class research program that I've been working on now for the last 10 years, and it really all comes down to be able to be given that freedom and that space and that investment that I think helped made it a success.
Cambridge is a fantastic place to do research and to teach in economics and finance. So we're 45 minutes by train from London, which is the global capital of finance in the world. Two, there's probably more historical financial data in Cambridge than anywhere else in the world. So for example, many of the colleges of Cambridge are centuries old. Right now we're in a college that's more than 600 years old. And they all have endowments. So you have many centuries of financial returns data that currently I've been working with and digitizing some historical data. And not just from English colleges. There's a wealth of resources here. So many people come to Cambridge who are movers and shakers, both in business and in policy. So it's really a fantastic place to do research.
In terms of science, the best thing about working in Cambridge and being in Cambridge is, first of all, the legacy. Like, lots of great scientists have been educated in Cambridge. And the first address I lived in Cambridge was Turing Way, which was, sounded so incredible to me. Following on from this legacy, there's still great science. And I feel like you're only limited by the questions you want to ask. And then you can pursue anything you want here because you are provided with the latest technology, the latest data available in any field you might be interested in.